After last night's show, we were happy, so we slept quite late. We got up by 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning. We had lovely hot croissants and such sweet, juicy oranges and a heavy breakfast. We went out to explore the city of Tromsø. We went to the souvenir shops. All along the pathway were lovely souvenir shops. Just posing with a real stuffed bear and a real reindeer. Oh, keep me warm, I told this real stuffed polar bear. There were two polar bears in Tromsø, and the city had two bears which they had to kill. I will tell you the story later. I'm posing in front of a bird which is capewheel. It is an aggressive cock-like bird. I had seen it in the Finland area of Arctic tundras. And the male is so aggressive that it had really come on us. And so just to recollect my memory, I have posed with this bird which is down. After that, we retired back to our home, to our hotel. We slept for some time, got up by 4:30, tried to wear all our warm clothes since 5:45 was reporting time at the bus station. Today, at our minibus tour, we had Alex as our guide. He explained a lot of theory. He said, how does the northern lights occur? They are caused by solar particles interacting with the Earth's magnetic field and atmosphere. When the sun's charged particles collide with oxygen and nitrogen, they emit these colors. The color green comes from oxygen, and nitrogen is when the pink and the purple comes out. He told us some myths about the northern lights. Can you touch these lights? No, they are very, very high up in the air, atmosphere. If you whistle at the lights, do they dance? No, they do not. The dance of the aurora is due to the solar wind and the geomagnetic storms. The local people are called Sami, and these Sami people believe that the northern lights are the spirits of their ancestors. They believe that the lights are a sign of good fortune and that they have the power to heal and protect the people from harm. Alex told us that we were going southwards in a different place called Somore, and he expected very clear sky. Unfortunately, when we arrived there, it was totally overcast, and we would never have got to see the aurora. So he decided we take a U-turn and drive more southwards towards a place called Tak Watnet, and it was quite a long journey. We arrived at that place, and it was completely clear sky, lucky for us, and even Alex saw some faint northern lights. We waited there, and the lights started growing brighter and brighter, giving us a lovely show. They faded a little in the middle, but then it gave us time to catch our breath and make a lovely campfire for ourselves. Then the sky became brighter and brighter. and we could really, really enjoy the aurora. Look at these few slides where we all are trying to pose with the northern lights. This is Mickey. This is me giving a wow effect. Another pose, Gopi. Yeah, he is really feeling cold. Enjoying the aurora. Posing, surely. Wearing the long coat, finally, he's feeling very, very, very cold. Here was the dance of the aurora. Again, another pose, enjoying the lights behind. See the pink phase which is coming up here. A pink dance as well. All of us posing away. Mickey has gone back to the bus. She's feeling extremely cold. We were out from 5:45 till 4:30 a.m. What taught us here is to be extremely, extremely patient. If you are patient and you focus, you can definitely see the lights. The lights here started only after 1 a.m. And so after we enjoyed 2-3 hours of northern lights, we returned back to our cozy warm beds at 4:30 in the morning. Await my next day at Tromsø.